guys, welcome to the channel. My name is Mr. Prince, and today I'll be reviewing the manual The Peerless Concubine, written by Yo Dao Ming. This manual follows the story of a lady who got reincarnated into another person's body. Pretty standard stuff. Okay, not technically standard, but reincarnation is not new in manuals today. There are tons of reincarnation stories. It follows the adventure of this lady as she embarks on a journey to fix her face. She's said to be ugly, but isn't ugly in the manual, but I guess artistic quality, I don't know. But she set back to fix her face and to fix all those who wronged her family or the person she got reincarnated into her body. So there are a couple of things I like about this story. I quite won't go into much spoilers, so you can get to read it if you want to. It values resources because it's like every manual these days has to do with an alchemist making pills and everything, and it's one of the few ones I've seen in a while that they actually make the pills make sense. It's not just everywhere. It shows the value of the pill. It's not like, yeah, they take these pills, but there's still kind of disparity between them. They never really show that well, which they took the time to actually show in this manual. It also has an okay naming system, as I'll say. It's not like, so like he has his yellow star, his red star, his heavenly star, those stupid naming. It has an okay naming system. But which I'll start with the drawbacks right now. The power scaling is weird. For his show that for any manual that emphasizes on naming the power scaling, they just throw numbers out to the end. They don't make sense. They just throw numbers. Is a martial artist? Is a martial artist level 5? A martial artist level 2? Like they don't really talk about it. Just throw the names and the numbers out there, which is kind of weird. It's like, if you are going to focus on something, focus on it. At least, if you're going to tell me you are weak, tell me how weak you are compared to this person. Don't just say, you have to be at least this level. What level are you? We don't know that. They just skip over those details, which is kind of weird. Another negative to this manga is that there are stupid characters in this stuff. Like, characters literally get beaten, and then they come back again, and then they get beaten, and then they come back again. Like what the heck? If someone is going to trash me every point of time, why would you keep coming back there when the person can easily kill you? It's like they don't wisen up, which is weird. Like even manuals I have issues with, they don't do this. If someone if someone beats you, you leave the story. You can upload the revenge with meeting somebody better, like get someone stronger to come and meet the person. Don't come back to fight the person again without nothing. Just because you want to fight the person. That doesn't, it was really getting to when I'm reading it. It was like, what is this? Like, just keep scrolling and be like, who are these characters? Now, another major issue I have with it, which I feel is the biggest issue with the story has no goal in mind. So, because there's no goal, there's no tension in the story. Like, it's just bland, no goal, no tension. And the goals can be done in several different ways. You can have a long-term goal like most manga do, and you can have a short-term goal, a series of short-term goals, a series of list of things you have to do, which all works, or you can have both, which works best. You have a long-term goal, which is like in the foreseeable future when you can get there. But for the meantime, you have to do some things. It makes you feel like you're getting closer to something. And when things happen, it makes you feel like this thing came from my goal. But it's not like that. She just wakes up one day, some challenges are, once the character challenges are, she fights them. She does things on the whim, creates a lot of enemies for herself just so she can fight them. And then there was one scene where she was supposed to be fighting someone that she wasn't strong enough, and I didn't get why she chose to fight the person. She had like literally no reason, just so that they could progress the plot further. It's weird, what I'm saying. Okay, let me talk about the art. The art is actually pretty good. It's on a web strip, like webtoon strip, so it's pretty nice, and I give props to the artist. He knows how to draw his stuff. It's okay, I'll give it a 6 if you're in terms of that. So okay, I did give the art a 6. Let me give my scoring for everything. For the story, I'll give it a 4. It's pretty mediocre. There's really not much to do there. It's just bland. You can use it to while away time, but there's really not much to be added here. You don't go from the story being like, oh wow, I got something like this. You don't go away from that. You can forget the story like I read the story, I forget like in minutes. The art's pretty okay. I'll give it a 6. It's above average, for at least manhwas these days. It's pretty nice. And then I think the characters, one, they are mostly stupid characters, and that's the like it's one of the biggest drawbacks. This the novel and the characters, they are just stupid. Even the main character, it's like it's okay, she's decent, but even she just makes trouble, and she doesn't have any vision in mind. She just does things on sway. Like someone talks to her and said, "Oh, why don't you join this sect? Oh, this sect seems to be the best sect in the church," which we never thought before. She never had any intention of joining it. Someone just mentioned it to her, and then now we are in this arc where she's supposed to join the sect and enter the sect, and then that's the character approaches. Which are apparently, I'm sure. Okay, I stopped reading it at that point. I'm still going to keep recalling. I just keep causing trouble for no apparent reason, but just wants to cause trouble because apparently, when you get beaten multiple times, if you keep going at it, you won't get beaten. You finally beat the person. Like, come back with somebody, come back with the weapon, come back with do something, plot a scheme. So, with that, I'll give the total of four. It's mediocre. If you can use it while you wait, and there's really no problem with that. You just read it and just keep scrolling. Like I was literally even using my phone case here, but it's like just like If you're bored, I have nothing best else to do. You can watch it, but you have something else to read. I would advise reading that instead. The story is not really it's not really that great. But with that, I end the video. I would like you to subscribe, or as Nox would say it, subscribe. Later, alligator.